Hello guys, in today's video we'll be solving the problems under coefficient of variance, which is very very important for 14 marks, and this question is asked in 2016. Basically you have to remember the coefficient of variance formula. CV is equals to standard deviation divided by x bar into 100. This is very very important. Okay, I'll just read out the question. Following are the marks obtained by two students, Suraj and Dheeraj, in 10 tests of 100 marks each. So they're trying to say there are two students who have attended 10 tests, and the below data are their marks out of 100 in each subject. These are the tests from 1 to 10. They've given the number series, and these are the marks obtained by Suraj, this is the data. By Dheeraj, this is the data. Now what you have to do is, first you need to just extract the coefficient of variance of only Suraj. The question, the solution is, I've written the test, that is, the test doesn't mean it's a frequency, it is just a serial number that they have given you. And so the information of Suraj, the data of Suraj is written as X. They have not given us the frequency. So you need not have to worry about it. But please don't consider this test series as a frequency. It's just a serial number. Whatever the data given under Suraj is just the values under X. Now, for coefficient of variance, we should identify mean as well as standard deviation. First step is identification of mean. Formula is x bar is equals to sigma x divided by n. I repeat, this is only sigma x divided by n. So what is the sigma x? The total of this column, that is 608, divided by n is the number of series, that is 10. So 608 divided by 10, you are getting mean answer is 60.8, which is approximately 61. Now the second step that we have to identify is standard deviation according to the formula. Standard deviation is equals to root sigma x square divided by n. Please don't add frequency here because they have not given the frequency in the question. So it's only sigma x square divided by n. To find out this x square, my next column is identifying the x. X is identified by x minus x bar. X bar, we have already identified it to be 61. So this 61 needs to be deducted under all the values of the given observation. That is 40 minus 61 is minus 21. 80 minus 61 is 19. 76 minus 61 is 15. Similarly, all these values should be deducted under 61. You have to write down with the negative symbols, positive symbols, whatever you have got. Immediate next column is x square. Whatever the x that you have identified here is, that has to be done to the power of 2. Please make sure, don't just make this x column to the power of 2. It is only the x which you have identified here, that is capital X. So x square is 21 into 21, 441, 19 into 19, 361. Similarly, for all the values, you have to multiply it with the power of 2, that is square. You will be getting these answers. Just total that column, you get 1498. Now derive the formula. Sigma x square, that is 1498 divided by n is the number of observation, that is 10. So 1498 divided by 10, you get 149.8. If you make a square, if you press a root for that, you get standard deviation answer is 12.23. Now calculating coefficient of variance is very easy because you have already identified mean, you have already identified standard deviation. So coefficient of variance, I've written the formula, standard deviation divided by x bar into 100. Standard deviation in the answer that you have identified is 12.23 divided by mean is 61 into 100, you get 20.05. See, whenever you are solving the problem under coefficient of variance for 14 marks, make sure you have to write this symbol, because coefficient of variance means you are identifying the percentage of the consistency of a particular person or a object. Similarly, you have to do the calculations for Dheeraj. So far, we did the calculations for Suraj. these calculations. In the same method, only by taking Dheeraj data you have to calculate it. See, I've written test under x, these are the data of Dheeraj. Again identify x square, identify mean, standard deviation, and come to the coefficient of variance. Now most importantly, you have to give a conclusion. See, I've written the three important points here. First one is, we calculate coefficient of variance for comparing the variables uniformity and consistency of two or more distributions. So you should know, why do we do coefficient of variance? To know their uniformity and consistency. Next, notice the values of coefficient of variance are always represented in percentage. Please don't forget to write percentage symbol. The last and the most important note here is, lesser the value of coefficient of variance, more consistency in the distribution, and vice versa, which means the coefficient of Suraj is 20.05 and the coefficient of Dheeraj is 14.48. Please don't get confused and write Suraj is better, because they say under coefficient of variance, whoever gets the less is the best. So the conclusion here is, Dheeraj is better scorer than Suraj. According to consistency of coefficient of variance of Dheeraj is less than Suraj. Last point is, Dheeraj will get the prize. Similarly, the second problem asked in 2015, I'll be sending you guys the photos, you can solve and see. It is also asked in 2017, it is also asked in the year 2018, so it is asked in 2018. The another different kind of question that they may ask you under this coefficient of variance is by giving you the continuous frequency. This is quite important. They're asking you, you are given the below the daily wages paid to workers in two factories, that is X and Y. Which factory pays higher average wages? Which factory pays more total wages? And last question is, in which factory are wages more variable? Okay, so the question given here is daily wages and number of workers. This daily wages is the class interval that they have given, and this X and Y is the frequency. Please note it, these are frequencies that they've given. Number of workers is nothing but of frequencies. So I'm starting with the first format, that is X. This is X company, X, and this is Y. I have divided it like that. So the first calculation for X is, write down the class interval. This class interval will be same for both X and Y company. I've written the class interval, I've written the frequency, that is 30, 60, 90, 40 and 20. Now immediate next step is identifying the mid value by keeping this class interval as a base, that is 50 plus 60 divided by 2, you get 55. Similarly, you need to do the calculations for all the steps and write down. Okay, now you may be thinking, which are the next columns that we have to solve. First, write down the formula so you will know which are the columns to be solved. First is identifying mean. X bar is equals to sigma fx divided by n. Here you can see f because they've given frequency in the question. So fx is there, I have to find out the fx. X is the mid value, which I've already found out. These two columns, f into x, if I make, I am getting fx, total that fx column. Now simplify the formula, 17,600 divided by total of frequency n, 240, you are getting 73.33, which is approximately 73. The next formula to identify is standard deviation. Formula is root sigma fx square divided by n. So another column which I have to identify is, first I should identify x and then x square and then fx square. So x, capital X, x is equals to x minus x bar. X bar is the mean which I've already identified, 73. Write down here 73. So all these x value needs to be deducted by 73 step by step, that is 55 minus 73 minus 18, 65 minus 73 minus 8. Similarly, you need to deduct and write down the values. The next column is x square. Whatever the x that values you have identified, you need to multiply it to the power of 2. You'll be getting these answers. Next step is fx square. This f into x square, these values, if you make, you will get the fx square column. I've done the total, it is 29,360. Now, simplify the formula. Fx square is 29,360, which I've identified, divided by n is 240. So, for that you get 122.33. If you make root for it, you get 11.06. The last step is calculations of coefficient of variance. Standard deviation divided by mean into 100. What is standard deviation? It is 11.06. Divided by mean is 73. Into 100, you get 15.15. The same calculation should also be done for Y company. So how do you do it? The class interval is the same. You are writing the class interval same. Only the frequency will change. Whatever frequency is given for Y company, you are writing down. The next column calculations are same, like keeping this as base. Identify the mid value X and then F into X, you get this column. Identify X. First, before that, you should identify mean and then identify this column. Make a square root of this column. Lastly, this F into X square column, you get FX square column. Just simplify the formula like how you did for X company. Only these two are the different types of questions will be asked for coefficient of variance, but this is very, very important for 14 marks. Make sure you will please attend this question. It is very, very easy method and solution as well. Thank you.